Hafiza Hamra Kamal from Chongqing University of Post and Telecommunication, Chongqing, China. I'm a PhD student. I'm going to present my presentation. Title is A Convolutional Neural Network for the Identification of Diseases in Rice Crop. I will explain about introduction and existing work, research objectives, research design and methodology, results and discussion, and the last one is conclusion. Rice is human food around the world and staple food in Asia. About half of the people rely on rice. Pests and diseases are harmful to the crops, which reduces crop production that leads to food insecurity. The pests and diseases also cause severe yield losses in rice. The diseases such as bacterial common diseases in the rice crops are bacterial leaf blight, leaf smut, and brown spot. The manual observation of diseases rice through naked eyes is a traditional and non-effective method, and it requires more time and expertise. In traditional methods, the diseases are identified when huge damages occur, resulting in wastage of time and resources. Therefore, the use of modern approaches for timely and accurate disease detection is becoming more important. The most modern approaches are neural networks, machine learning, deep learning, used for fast, accurate, and automatic disease detection through image classification. Existing work, the study on disease detection through neural networks was conducted by Al-Harry et al., who found an accuracy of 94%. Fuzzy logic was also employed by Pomegranz to grade disease on leaves, and segmentation was carried out using k-means clustering. Use the automatic method for disease detection in sugar beet and found an accuracy of 86% using Gaussian mixture model. However, the use of convolutional neural network is a modern neural networks are more efficient and accurate, identify the pest and disease, spread very quickly. The research objective is to, we have used the rice disease were classified by training the off-the-shelf standard convolutional neural network. The pre-trained residual neural network ResNet 50 was taken from ImageNet. The objective and focus things are to identify the leaf diseases are bacterial leaf blight, leaf smut, and brown spot, to develop a system for timely and accurate detection of rice diseases. Collection of rice disease images and annotation. The RGB high quality images were collected from the various farm fields during 2019. The images of diseases were collected various angles and different noise conditions with the using of a camera to reflect real scenarios. Images on the divert background, different period images at various different growth stages of rice crops, various focus disease and various diseases in a similar image. Here are images of three diseases: bacterial leaf blight, the second one is brown spot, and the third one is leaf smut rice. These diseases are cause of fungal. Classification of rice diseases through standard convolutional neural network. The rice diseases were classified by training the off-the-shelf convolutional neural network. The diseases bacterial leaf blight, leaf smut, and brown spot, and few complex leaves, which are diseases on the same leaf, were used in the classification. The pre-trained residual neural network was taken from the ImageNet of network was previously carried out by the fine-tuning of these networks was performed on the collected data using the it is a method in which half data were used for training and half data used for testing. We have divided into 80% and 20%. 80% data used for training and 20% data used for testing. Here is a flow diagram of the methodological system adopted for rice disease identification. Further, I would like to explain about results and discussion. Here is the table where you can see the accuracy. The results show that high accuracy was achieved from the ResNet 50, which ranged from 75% to 91% in different batches. The overall accuracy is 83%. The training losses of convolutional neural network were very low, which ranged from 0.005 to 0.023, while the validation losses were 0.22 to 0.433. The losses were higher during early epoch batches. After that, a decreasing trend was observed. Overall, the validation losses are higher than the training losses over time and showed that model performance is well. There is stability in learning curves, which indicates that the model is well fitted and can be used for disease identification. Here is the confusion matrix between actual and predicted rice diseases and the learning curves to assess the performance of convolutional neural networks time. In the current study, only online sources of convolutional neural network were used for classification of disease identification. Images collected from farm level to detect the early season disease detection, which will helpful for farmers to apply pesticides and remove the disease infected and chance for the outbreak. In rice season, the diseases are identified by the expert or few samples are tested. Remote laboratories which need a huge human resources and money. In our trained model can be used for early disease detection without any chemical test. The current study results showed a test accuracy of 83% from the convolutional neural network. Another researcher found an accuracy of 89% for apple disease detection. The higher accuracy symptoms of the disease on leaves and images were also collected from the control condition. The current study was conducted for the timely and accurate detection of rice diseases done by standard convolutional neural network. The quality images of rice disease leaves of bacterial leaf blight, leaf smut, and brown spot were required. The pre-trained residual neural network ResNet 50 was used for classification. 80% of data were used for training and 20% for testing. The result indicates that the high accuracy was achieved from the ResNet 50 range from 75 to 91%, and the overall accuracy we found 83%. The learning curve showed that training and validation losses reduced time over time to a stability less difference to the final losses values. Therefore, the model is considered to be well fitted. The modern deep neural networks are valuable methods for disease classification and identification. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you for your wonderful presentation. I just want to know, like, which software you used for neural network analysis?
Hello?
Which software you used for neural network to create, you know, these curves and analyzing the matrix?
I used online resources with Paperspace and Google Colab.
Okay.
Can I say something?
No, please.
Hello?
Yeah. Please.
Hello?
Go
ahead. Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah. Thank you for your presentation. It was good, rich of information, but also I advise you to minimize the quantity of information. Your pages are contains a lot of information which construct or distract the audience. So I advise you to summarize the most important information and put it in your presentation. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your suggestion.
Thank you.
Good observation. Thank you, Asma. And thank you, Amra, for your wonderful presentation.